Hello, my name is Emily Gary, and I was one of the semester international program students here in Pembroke College. I matriculated in January of 2006 with a wonderful group of dynamic students. Since then, I went on to teach in international programs while I did my MPhil in the history of art and my PhD in the history of art here in Pembroke. Since then, I went on to become a fellow at Merton College, Oxford in the history of art, and now I'm a lecturer in Gothic art and architecture at the University of Kent in Canterbury. And it's such a delight to be back here because now my sister is studying here too.
Yeah, hello, I'm Charlotte Gary. I'm her little sister, and I've just started the semester program. I just matriculated, and it's January 2017, so a few years later. I currently attend the University of Southern California, where I study film and visual arts. So I'm studying history of art here. I'm very excited. I've just begun, so we'll see.
Hey, so what did you enjoy about being on the semester program while you were here?
The semester program was an absolute delight, but the thing I really enjoyed the most about it was it taught me how to think, it taught me how to work, and it taught me how to use my imagination to understand more about art history. In addition to being surrounded by really vibrant, passionate, enthusiastic, weird people like myself who love old buildings and old places, I was able to use a library of international sort of renown. I was able to attend lectures by global experts in the field, and I was able to sort of share a seminar space with other students who loved the art as much as I did. When I was here in 2006, I took two TRIPOS papers, one by Professor Jean-Michel Massing on the art of Albrecht Dürer, and another on medieval Rome, delivered by Claudia Bolgia and Professor Paul Binsky.
I feel very fortunate to be Emily's sister because she shared her love of Pembroke with me, and it's because of her I decided to apply, because I too really crave a learning experience that's as intensive and as wonderful as the time she had here. I am currently studying Surrealism under Alice Mahon, Dr. Alice Mahon, and I will be studying the English art and architecture of the Renaissance with a supervisor named Jane Partner, Dr. Jane Partner. I'm so excited for what's to come, and I hope that I will come back to the United States with a greater love of learning and a greater sense of history than I have right now. And I'm sure I will.
So, Emily, how has it shaped your life post-semester program?
Well, after I did my semester here in 2006, I couldn't help but try to become a medieval art historian. So I came back to Pembroke, and I came back to the History of Art Department to do my graduate work. And I finished with an MPhil and a PhD in the History of Art here. And since then, I've continued to publish on Gothic art and architecture. And I think I really sort of fell in love with it here. Not only was I surrounded by a 14th century college, but every day when I walked to the library and walked to meet a friend for coffee, I would see a beautiful chapel. I would know that, you know, this college is older than my country. And it just, I couldn't help but think, this is what I want to do. I want to understand more about this, and I want to share my passion with other students now that I've learned about it. So without IP, I don't know if I'd be a professor of medieval art history, and I'm so, so grateful that I had the opportunity to learn here, to live here, and to sort of fall in love with the subject here.
So, Charlotte, what's your impression of Pembroke so far?
Well, my impression of Pembroke so far is, that it's an extraordinary place, and as Emily said, it has a very deep history, much deeper than I've experienced in my time in the U.S. I am so excited when I walk down the street. I'm so excited to, you know, explore different parts of Cambridge, and especially being in Pembroke to have this wonderful chapel, which was designed by Christopher Wren, one of the great English architects, and to go into the library and get to study in a room with stained glass, and, you know, to be surrounded by so many bright, lovely people. I feel very fortunate to be here, and I know that it will cement a love for history and a love for England and a love for Cambridge that I've always wanted to have since I knew that this place existed.
Yeah, it's really the people here that are so amazing. That's another thing just to reiterate, is that at Pembroke you have a real community. It's a place where people work hard, but they think and they're fun, and they welcome people from all over the world and make you feel like you belong here too. And yeah, so it's been a pleasure. Yeah.